Yeah.
Yeah, and trying to do that, it would have been not fair to Wade. It would not been fair to the fans. That's why Astronomicus sounds the way it does, and why Wade sounds the way he does. You know, we made him to let him be himself.
Yeah, so and Wade, he's awesome. Wade's awesome. Wade's awesome at what at his style. Mm-hmm. We just happen to have a different style. That's all.
Yeah. Exactly. And as far as Crimson Glory, you know, going forward, you know, we knew that in order to make, you know, future records and to go forward, that we wanted to recapture some of the things, you know, on some of the early records that Midnight was able to have, give to band. That we wanted the singer to have more of those elements that had the essence of Midnight within him. And Todd, you know, thank God, unfortunately, lives right here in our own backyard, and he was able to show us that he got it. He has that soul in him, that essence of him that makes Crimson Glory unique. And we spent a year now getting to know each other, you know, not just getting a singer from some other place in the world and coming in and singing a record like so many records do. So many bands with great singers, and singers are great, but they're not really friends, they're not really that close, they don't really spend time together. They're just, you know, like, hey, you're hiring a guy to come in.
Mm-hmm.
I wanted a singer to be my friend, my brother. I wanted to hang out and get to know the person and spend time doing things outside of music together. So that way, when we create music, there's a bond there. It's not something that's orchestrated or create or manipulated or fake. It's not just talent being thrown to record. It's true friendship. It's true. You know, we have a relationship now. We're friends.
Mm-hmm.
We do everything. We do a lot of things together outside of just writing music and performing. So now we have a true band member in our band. We have a true brother in our band, not just a great singer.
That's great, man. That's great. I'm really happy for you. Great. Todd, your first and only live performance with the band was at last year Prog Power Fest as part of the Midnight tribute show. What can you tell us about that moment?
Well, basically, you know, I was honored to be a part of the lineup. Certainly, they had some very well, you know, world-renowned singers within the genre. You know, I had one shot to do it right. You know, luckily enough, I was able to duo songs with three singers. One of them was with Wade. And, you know, certainly I didn't want to embarrass myself on stage. I wanted to make the band proud. I wanted to do the most justice to Midnight's legacy and... you know, I had a great time. It was awesome. I got to meet a lot of cool people. I got to bond with the band a little bit more. Wade and I and Jeff went to Texas or to Georgia together, so we got to hang out more. Overall, it was an awesome experience. I got to play in front of 1,500 plus people, and you know, it was nice. I've performed hundreds of shows as a drummer.
Mm-hmm.
Not in front of 1,500 people at once, but, you know, I've been playing music since I was 13. And so then I wasn't really as nervous. Once I got out there and blasted the first note of that song, I started to feel more comfortable.
Which was Mayday, by the way. It was the first note of Mayday,
yeah.
By the way, you know, from my perspective, you understand, like when Todd did Mayday, I'd offered that song Mayday to, 18 other different singers that were performing with us that night.
Wow.
And really, none of them stepped up and really wanted to do it, because none of them really felt that they could do it, to be honest. They were like, wow, I don't know, man. I don't know if I could do that one. You know, no, I don't know about that, man. Because I was actually asking all the singers, which songs would you like? Which ones would you prefer? So I was trying to get the singers on the songs they really wanted to sing. Nobody really wanted to step up and sing Mayday. Because it really is amazing high notes that really take a lot out of a singer.
Yeah.
So Todd, you know, Todd said, "Hey, I'll do it." You know, so when we did it in rehearsal one night, and he did it, it was like we knew we got the. He was just amazing. Like, wow, he actually did it, and he wasn't really nervous doing it. So you know, you had a guy on stage who didn't know what the front was from the front and the back. I mean, Todd has never been on stage, you know, as a singer before.
No.
So that was fun to see. You know, I was excited for him. You know,
yeah.
Yeah. The look on your faces, on the other bandmates, reflect such joy, you know. You were enjoying the night.
Oh, yeah, for sure. It was a great night. And remember, it was for Midnight. I wanted people, because the last time Midnight had performed at Prog Power, he he was, you know, not in great shape, and he put on a really kind of a crazy show, and people were, like, dogging him and not really saying nice things about Midnight, and I wanted to go back and remind him, you know, who Midnight really was. This is the guy who's made some one of the great metal records of all time, one of the great singers of all time, mm-hmm. and I wanted people to hear those songs live again and remember what singer did them. Okay. You know, that's why, you know, all the singers, you know, appeared with us. We had over 18 different singers, you know, and I said something on stage. I said, hey, Midnight was so amazing, it takes 18 singers to replace him in one night.
And that's no joke.
Yeah, you know, and now Todd's, you know, doing a full set with Crimson Glory, and he's realizing just how amazingly difficult it is. But
oh, yeah.
I tell you, I mean, I would have been confident going on that stage in Atlanta last year with Todd, seeing all the music. But keep in mind, Todd only had 2 weeks to prepare himself
mm-hmm.
for that show. So that was out of the question, but I tell you, if it were not just a benefit, and if it were not just for Midnight, I would have been happy having Todd Gattori be the lead singer the whole night long, because I think he would have done all the songs better than all the singers who performed that night.
Yeah.
And many of the singers, you know, that did it, did a great job. They were really good.
Yeah, Todd, they did a great job.
Yeah, but Todd has that extra X factor
mm-hmm.
that makes him truly special, makes him truly one in a million. And the other singers, once they heard Todd sing, they were all as impressed as I was. And they were all, they couldn't believe that he had never sang before. They were all like, wow, you obviously you've been singing for a long time, haven't you? And Todd was like, no. Todd was like just doing his thing, you know, and I mean, I'm just proud of him because he just went for it. He had nothing to lose. So, like I explained mm-hmm. to him before we did the show, you have nothing to lose and everything to gain. So
mm-hmm.
go out there, do what you've done in practice, and believe me, you'll be good enough.
Mm-hmm.
And he did great.
I'm very hard on myself, so that encouragement was awesome to hear from John, who, you know, everyone wants to meet the band, and, you know, so to hear that type of encouragement just help to ease my nerves and relax, and I'm really looking forward to playing these shows in front of the hardcore fans that know every word to every song, they know every guitar lick, they mm-hmm. you know, this their music, they know it. So when I can start feeding off of that energy over, you know, an entire set, you know, sometimes you know, some of your best work comes out of just the spur of the moment, and you're feeding off that energy. So I'm really looking forward to just the experience alone.
That's great. You know what's really great is that on these shows we're going to be doing over in Europe, we're going to be playing a lot of songs that we hadn't done in so long, or some of them we never really did that at all. Because even, you know, Midnight, you know, unless he was really in a good frame of mind, or he was healthy, he couldn't even do his own songs sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
So in some ways, people are going to get, you know, these songs and hear them better than they've ever been performed live before. We're going to be able to do songs like Burning Bridges or Dream Dancer. Like, you know, like we've never
heard Angels of War or something.
Angels of War, yeah. And even songs like Lost Reflection,
mm-hmm.
Todd does so well that the fans are just going to be so amazed that they're going to hear the song the way it exactly sounds like on the record.
Okay, Todd, as a vocalist, who could you point out as your main inspirations?
Well, that's pretty simple. I would say that the top two vocalists, two or three, would have to be Bruce Dickinson, right out of the gate, Jeff Tate, probably Ronnie Dio, and Rob Halford. Those are probably the top picks.
Yeah, and now Midnight.
uh-huh.
And now Midnight, yeah. Well, a lot of, you know, the first time I ever heard an Iron Maiden song, I came in late into Iron Maiden. It was with Bruce Dickinson, not with Paul Di'Anno.
Mm-hmm.
The first time I ever heard that real heavy vibrato, it just touched something inside of my soul that I was like, that is the best thing I've ever heard. That's what I love that sound. So most of the music, metal music that I listen to, has to have that type of a power, that heavy vibrato. That's why I was a big fan of Jeff Tate. I think he conveyed more emotion
mm-hmm.
than Bruce Dickinson in certain ways. He would have a little more of the crying sounds and breathy, but they were both just, you know, unbelievable singers to me. And those are the guys that I tried to copy. Those are the guys that when I'm driving around in my car, you know, and I'm singing Queensryche or Iron Maiden, I'm trying to sound like they sound.